on the line is Bobby Simeonis of Sigma, a soccer academy. Bobby, welcome again.
Hi, Anthony. Pleasure to be on.
Pleasure to have you on. Bobby, sometimes you got to sit back and say to yourself, wow, we're doing some good things here. Looking at the list of your players that have gone on to success, most recently Kyle Larin, Kyle Becker with TFC, and so many others that a lot of us have not heard of that I'm sure doing great overseas. How gratifying, how rewarding is that for you and all your staff?
I mean, it's great. When you look at it long-term, that's what you want to see, that players come through a system, a systematic way of training, and they're able to keep on playing this game beyond youth football, and that's what we need here in Canada as much as we can.
Bobby, let's talk about the ingredients that go into your soccer academy. It is one of the best in all of North America. There's no secret about that. MLS clubs contact you. You've got some of the best in NCAA schools. But how do you go about yourself and your staff, choosing, picking, selecting the players you want to go to your academy and travel with you all over the USA and Europe? Is there a checklist that you and your staff go over?
Yeah, I mean, first and foremost, we're looking for technical players, and that's what we want to do. Football always supersedes everything. So the ability to play on the field gives you a good education, and when you get to that next level, if you can play football, then you can do the rest for a coach. It's the reverse that always hinders a player's development going forward. So we're not looking so much for the size and the athletic attributes at the younger ages, but getting the players on the ball, many touches on the ball, and really refining them as total football players going forward, soccer players, as much as we can.
How important is it, Bobby, that player that you're selecting to be part of your family has that vision on the field, has that understanding of what style of football you want them ingrained in their mind?
Yeah, I mean, we have a specific way of doing things. We have a culture, I think, which is very important here at Sigma, and that's important for a player to develop through. You need the culture within an organization. And the guys that come in here from under 12 all the way up to our first team this year, which will play in League One, for the most part, we all play the same way. We all have the basic same principles of play from what we do on the field. And that's the best thing that the player can have in their development, is have that consistency, have the ability to express themselves, have the freedom on the field to express themselves, and to be a technically dominant player.
Some of the times we forget that there's so many aspects of developing that young player, not just on the field, but also off the field, whether it's dissecting some video of a previous game, looking at where that individual can get better, also nutrition, the diet, and that sort of thing. Do you go over all these things as well before you bring in that player to your family?
Yeah, I think we touch on a lot of those things. One of the most important things that we work on off the field is the mental aspects. It's players understanding mentally what it takes to keep on getting better, the patience that's needed to be a player in the long term, and really having a mentality from that aspect that it's not where we are right now, but it's where we are 5 to 7 years from now. That is very important. We don't need our teams at U12, at 14, at 16 to win games.
And that's fantastic.
The only team that's mandated to win around here is our first team. And even with them, we still need those players to develop, because usually there are college players, and from within that group, we need those players to make that next step to the professional level.
I love hearing that, Bobby. I'm glad you said that. How important is it, Bobby, that you and your staff go over to each and every player their role on that team, that they communicate before the season kicks off, before you travel to a big showcase or a tournament, that their role is distinguished, whatever it might be? How important is it that you go 1v1 with that player and you discuss that role with them?
Yeah, I think that's one of the most important aspects. I mean, every player in Sigma has a file. It's kept online with all their technical information, all their game information, all their training evaluations. So that way it makes it very easy and tangible for a coach to sit down with a player and in a couple of minutes explain a few aspects of the game that maybe need to be better, but most importantly, reiterate what they're doing well. And that's one thing that's the most important thing when we're looking at youth development, is focusing on the positives with the player. Because a lot of times in the coaching aspect, we get caught looking at some negative things, but really what we need to do is bring out the best in players. We have a lot of good players in this country, but to play at the next level, you need to be excellent at something, at one thing on the field. So it's our job as coaches to make sure we bring out that excellent characteristic in that player. In the end of the day, a player like David Beckham became a super player in the world on the field because he was excellent at one thing on the field. Then he was good at other things, But that's what we need our players to do. And, you know, those are some examples we try and use with the players is we have to get you to excel at something. So focusing on the positive things is very important. And again, that goes into the mental preparation of the player on the field.
Bobby, you used the word excel, and I'm pretty sure you and I can agree upon this, that it is so important to excel in school, in education, in getting the marks you need, because you could be the best striker, the best goalkeeper in all of Canada, but if you don't have those marks, you ain't going to the NCAA and they won't accept you, correct?
Yeah, I mean, that's correct. And then in the end of the day, we want many of our players, even here at Sigma, to play at the pro level sooner than later. But we live in North America, and we currently have 20 professional teams, let's call that MLS. And so the opportunities aren't wide open as it would be in a country like Italy or Holland or Germany, where there's two or three or four tiers of professional football. So we really have to be careful and use what we have that's distinct here in North America. And currently, that's NCAA soccer. And when we look at it, it's making sure that the players are going to top programs, they're going to good environments. And with much of the NCAA soccer, when we're looking at the top end, they're running on budgets far more than many professional clubs that we can think of.
Bobby, just before we get to the new venture, your academy is getting into this weekend, and it is a big launch in League One. I want to talk to you about your players, and some of them might be ready to take off sooner than later to start a new venture in their life, a new challenge. Something that they're obviously looking forward to is lacing them up with an NCAA school. And you and I discussed this before coming on air, and I was curious to get your response, because I really haven't gotten anyone else's response on this. And it's simple. It's simply put, if a player is getting ready to start at NCAA in early August, do you, as an academy, try to, you know, maybe decrease the playing time of that player, you know, making sure that there's no injury that could take place? Or do you want that player to continuously get more and more playing time?
No, I think the most important thing we look at is everything is monitored. So we don't decrease playing time or training frequency and so on. But when it comes to the games, you know, we look to monitor things where guys aren't excessively playing 90 minutes. So we'll go into games and we cut up their minutes to 45 and 60 minutes, mostly not from an injury prevention aspect, but we also want those players to be fresh going into their fall season. And when we look at the training cycles of a player, you want to make sure that they don't dip when it comes in September, when it's very important for them to be playing well and produce at their university, who's made a pretty good investment in them being there through a scholarship. So, I mean, that's the important aspect that we look at from there.
Let me ask you this, Bobby. Obviously, you've had a lot of players go on to success in the NCAA, Boston College, you name it, all sorts of universities, Maryland, all over. There's been great success from many Canadian players. When they've made that decision, when they're going to make that voyage down south to play with that NCAA school, when the deal is all sealed and done with, let's take, for example, Boston College and Kyle Becker. Did Kyle take some time to go and study and watch some of the tape of Boston College and see what type of style they play, so he's getting ready, comfortable in his mind that he knows what style they're playing? Or do they get down there and they familiarize themselves as they make their way down there?
I think it always differs. I mean, when we're looking at a lot of the bigger programs, the players will get a lot of information before they go into camp. We also, as a staff here, we talk with the coaches down there just a little bit about style and expectations of those players coming into the season. So it's kind of a two-way thing where we're looking at it with the school itself, where the player is getting a lot of information that is needed directly from the school, and also me working together with a coach like Ed Kelly at Boston College to get as much information as needed to help the guys make a successful transition.
Bobby, you're going to start a new venture, League One. You have put a team in there. Unlike OPDL, where the academies were all shut out, the door was closed in their face, this is refreshing. This is welcoming to see not only your academy, but a couple others in League One. How excited are you to get this launched? But more importantly, why would you get involved in a new semi-pro league in Canada?
Yeah, I think like with every new venture, I think there's some excitement behind League One, and I think it's being built on a proper footballing premise, and I think that's why Sigma's at the table. When we look at the game, we always look at football first. So we always look at the game, what's best for players, what's best for the development, and overall what's best for Canadian soccer. So we think that down the road, you know, this is going to be a very good option for our players. At Sigma, we've always been a big supporter of senior football. You know, from our beginning, we've always had a first team because we believe within the culture of things, it's important for your players, whether they're 12 or 14 years old, to look up to some of our guys, and this is an important way to be able to build that. So I think as we go forward, I think League One has the ability, has the proper people working on it between the OSA and some of the organizations to get this right.
Safe to say you've got a dynamic duo up front starting in your first game, Kyle Larwin, who just played for Team Canada overseas, and Emery Welshman, a former TFC product. How exciting is that to have these two guys pairing up?
Yeah, I mean, it's always great. You know, you think of going back 5 years and you say, how can you put some of these guys on the field together? And fast forward, and here you have it. You know, you'll have quite a few good players. You mentioned Kyle Larin and Emery Welshman, but a lot of top guys who are playing at top programs in the U.S. NCAA soccer. And it's exciting for us to get these guys on the field. You know, they're slowly been filing back over this last month and working hard and training hard. And we look forward to Sunday and getting everything started.
Bobby, we know you got to get going, so we'll let you go. But just before we let you go, how important is it in your mind, where you've had so much success in sending players overseas into MLS, that everyone sings off the same hymn sheet at the CSA in regards to head coach Benito Flor? Everything underneath them has to fall in place, whether it's the technical director, youth coaches, you name it. Everyone has to fall in place. And if not, then that's when we're going to go back again and problems will arise. In your mind, is it key that everyone falls into place and follows the same protocol?
100%. I mean, if we look at the top of the structure, that's what we need, and every country has the top of the structure. I think Benito's doing a great job with the national team right now, and as much as that can trickle down from there and the support that he can get from underneath, and as much as we can do, whether it's League One, whether it's Sigma FC, you know, it's we're there to make sure they have the support and the tools that they need, because we need this national team program to succeed over the next few years. And I think the basis is there. You know, there's a lot of restructuring going on and rebuilding of the team, but we believe that he can get the job done, and we need to be able to support that going forward.
Bobby, great of you to join us once again. Good luck this season in League One. More importantly, keep developing those players for overseas and for Canada. And as we close it out, where can people get a hold of you if they might have a young man that might be interested in joining your player development? Is there a website? Is there a phone number? Where can they get a hold of you?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, yeah. To get more information on us, they can go to our website at www.sigma-sports.net, and they can get information about our organization there. And yeah, we look forward to seeing a lot of people in Ontario soccer out, not only at Sigma FC, but a lot of these League One games going forward, and supporting this new venture.
Outstanding.